everyone. Rachel coming at you today from our beautiful plots in Garden City, Kansas. We're out here doing our R3 biomass sampling today. I just wanted to come out to the plots and talk to you a little bit today about our hybrids. So for the last 3 years in all of our sites, not just here in Garden City, but we've got sites in Goodland, Greensburg, Bueller, Keats, Selkirk, Colby, a whole host of different places. We've used the same hybrids in all of our sites for the last 3 years, and those are both from Corteva Agriscience. P0657 and P0805, both with the Aquamax trait. And the reason that those hybrids were selected is because both of them are prone to tillering. And for a tillering project, that's probably something that you want in the hybrids you're using, right? So an interesting thing about both of those hybrids, corn hybrids usually last in the market only for about 4 years because the corn hybrids just don't perform as well after they've been in the market for some time. And so P0657 is phasing out, and I think P0805 will be in that category also soon. So it's really crazy, you know, cutting edge research. We're using hybrids that, because we've been doing this project for 3 years already, are starting to phase out. But we are not looking at tillering specific to hybrids. We're just using two hybrids to make sure we're being more fair with how we're evaluating things. So right now we're standing in one of our P0657 AM plots. And this is our lowest density, 10,000 per acre. You'll remember we have a 10,000, a 17,000, and a 24,000 plants per acre. But you'll notice behind me here, we've got lots of tassel ears in this plot. Most of the tillers in these plots developed as tassel ears. So you can see over here also, we have tassel ears back here. There was one by my head here, and then there's another one right over here. So lots of tassel ears in this plot. And the thing that's interesting is that it's not necessarily the hybrid that's the reason that we have these tassel ears, right? It's just something about this hybrid that caused us to have those tassel ears. So that could be that the tillers developed a little bit later in this hybrid, and the environmental condition that they experienced because they were developing a little bit behind might have led to those tassel ears. Because in Garden City, in 2020, for example, I did not see a single tassel ear in this entire field. For either hybrid in any density, there were none. Didn't see a single one. And this year, one of our hybrids, P0657, has a lot of tassel ears, and our other hybrid doesn't have many at all. P0805 doesn't have many. Let's go check out a P0805 plot. So here we are in a P0805AM plot. You'll notice that it looks a little bit different here. I feel a lot shorter standing in this plot because the plants are a whole lot taller, the tillers are bigger, there's a lot more biomass around me. Visually, you can tell just standing in this plot that we're gonna have much more biomass here than we had in the P0657. With the biomass sampling that we're doing today, we can confirm that also. But there's no tassel ears that have developed here. It's all either normal, or the plants don't have ears on them. The tillers don't have ears on them. The main plants do. But it'll be interesting to see the dynamics of how these two scenarios affect yields. If the plots with tassel ears are reduced and the plots without tassel ears are boosted or neutral, or if it's all neutral. And that's what we're looking forward to here in Garden City. This time of year, I always enjoy coming out to the plots because if you're going to see hybrid differences, now is when it really starts showing up, both when tillers are first appearing and then after pollination has happened, to see how those tillers developed, right? Because the tillers appear and then the tillers develop, and those are the two processes that we're really trying to understand in this project. Working to understand why we have these differences and what that could mean for other hybrids beyond P0657 and P0805. If the stages, when a cool spell came through or a hot spell came through, if the P0805 plants were a little bit less developed during that time, maybe the tassel was not developing yet, and so the environmental conditions experienced by P0657 that we saw with all the tassel ears was not present in P0805. And looking around, we can see that we don't have tassel ears. We do have some normal ears. Let me grab one here. So you'll notice it pollinated beautifully. This one's not very big. We do have some that are a little bit larger than this, but this is just the one that was right next to me, so I grabbed it. To be honest, right, not cherry picking our videos here, but as you can see, we have some discrepancy in the maturity of our ears, right? I get a lot of questions about this, about the differences in moisture when harvest rolls around, how this will affect that, if we should expect problems as far as combining goes. And I'll tell you that in the last 2 years, past 2 years, can't speak for 2021 yet, but in the past 2 years, we've never had an issue with tillers being that much more wet than the main ears were. By the time we get to that point, everything's kind of evened out. I think that the biggest difference that we've seen checking moisture as we're harvesting has been about 2 to 3%. So that's not something that you would really need to be concerned about. The tiller and the main ear are also developing within a reasonable distance of each other. So the picking it with the combine isn't a problem as far as the logistics of where those ears are located. But yeah, really cool to see some hybrid differences here in Garden City. Excited to see what the data looks like, what yields will do for us to come back at R6. We'll be back at R6 to get that harvest data. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.